Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to see about the access list. There are three type of access list is there. One is a standard, extended and named. Named is nothing but giving the name to the access list. This video we are going to see about only the standard access list. We are going to see only the standard access list. Okay. First, I will create some lab setup for that. What type of lab we can create? But I will take one router. Then I will take a two switch, or I will take two router to router to different network. Okay. I will take some switch. L2 switch. Okay. Then few PCs. Let it be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now let's make the connections for each router, switch and PC. Now the connectivity was done. Let's define the network. Okay, we can give 23.0/24. It should be 192.168.2.0/24. This should be 192.168.3.0/24. Okay. Now let's go and do the basic configuration stuff. I will configure the interface IP on this between these routers. Okay. Host name R1, first Ethernet 0/0, Similarly, you can configure all those things. Okay, I'm doing it in offline. Hi friends, the pre-configuration is done. These are the pre-configuration. This switch IP address is 192.168.2.10. This is 2.11. The router interface we configured with the gateway is 2.1. Similarly, the router 2, the interface is configured with 3.1 as a gateway. Now you can see the PC will be able to reach this network ping 192.168.2.10. Okay, but it will not able to reach 3.10 and 3.12. So there is no route available to reach 3. Network. Let's create a static route for that. This lab is mainly access list, but you will learn about how to create static route also. IP route, if any packet with the designated 3.0 network, okay, we need to add the destination prefix marks. There are two ways you can do. Either you can do it to the next hop address, or you can do it in next hop interface. Okay, can see the more details about my earlier video. I am giving next hop address. Okay, done. You can see now difference. Earlier you received destination host unreachable from 2.1. Now you are seeing the request timeout. So the packet is passing through R1 router. Okay. Now still the router is not reachable because the return route is not there. If you add the return route here, IP route 192.168.2.network. If any packet designated to 2.network, please route it to the next office 192.168.2.23.1. Okay, now you can go and see there is a full reachability is there. You can check the full reachability. Now we are set up with the full configuration. Now what is Windows standard access list? Now I don't want this PC to access my 3. network. I don't want this PC to access my any of the IP of 3. network. Now you're able to reach 3.10, 3.11. Okay. The first packet ARP entry is not there. ARP entry is once ARP entry was done, you can get other response. Okay. Now I want to restrict 192.168.2.1 to access my 3. network. What we can do? I will create access list, standard access list. Access list, standard access list number 1 to 99. I can give the name as a 1. Deny. Whether permit or deny, I want to deny is 192.168.2.1. So it's specifically I want to deny 192.168.2.1. 192.168.2.1. Then you can put a host, deny host 192.168.2.11. Now access list is created. Once access list created, it will work? No. Why? Because still you are not assign this to interface. You should block. You can block as much as destination is possible. Let me show you. R2 only I created. I am denying it here. How to deny it? Place it on interface. 6.0/fast ethernet 0/1. Right? Interface fast ethernet 0/1. IP access group. What is access group 1? What you need to do? Put inbound or outbound. Because it is towards destination, so put outbound. Now I put a outbound. Now you go and check whether you're able to reach or not. See what this denotes? Because the packet is reaching till this router. Okay. But it's not crossing that. So you're not able to ping any of the network. Right, 3.11 3.10. now I don't want to get this one. I want to block this while leaving this router itself. So first I will delete this one. Now IP access group 1 out. I deleted this one. Now you're able to reach. See, now I want to permit here. Access list 1, deny 192.168.2.11. I am, you can if you want to make it as a network. Okay, you need to put a wildcard mask. What is a wildcard mask? See, I am specifically blocking this one. If you want to specifically block this network, you can choose the wildcard mask accordingly. Now I want to apply this on interface. Config T. Sorry, already I am in a config T mode. Already I am in config T mode. Interface fast ethernet 0/1. IP access group 1 out. See, packet is not leaving this router. Debug IP. Can see the error message source 192.2.11. Okay, it's trying to reach 3.1. Okay, routed via RP because it is routing via routing information. So the packet is getting forwarded, still it's forwarding, but if you see that again, the return packet is coming. First Ethernet 0/0 and destination is this one. Still its packet is getting forwarded. When you see here, this encapsulation is failed. Okay, then it's trying to match the access list. The 2.11 is denied to go out. So the ICMP is failed. So you're not able to reach 3.1 and 3.11. Config D, the first fast Ethernet. 0/1, no IP, access group 1, out. See, so you should take care where we need to place the access list. It should be as close as the destination and standard access list, because if you want to restrict the specific IP, so it will be, if the specific IP to access all means you can block post access group here, but if you want to restrict to accessing 3.11, then it would be great if you place as close as the destination. If you are putting here, you can put a in. Okay, if you put in access list, then it will be close to the source. If you put out, close to the destination. Okay, I hope you enjoy the video. If you like this video, please give your feedback, subscribe and share to your friends. And the few comments I received, that's really good. They said that I need to improve the voice. I hope this voice is somewhat better. And another comment I received, you could place this packet tracer file in your link. So I will provide these details in my description. So you can go and download this link and you can practice it. Thanks for watching this video. We'll see you in the next video. Bye.